Now then, the next big thing, of course, is that we are going to launch a new plugin, machine learning. And I'll give you a few words first on what is machine learning and what is it good for and how can we use this in our seismic and well to seismic type of problems. Now, machine learning is basically good in finding complex relationships and structures in data sets from different sources with widely varying accuracies and scales. And that is, of course, exactly what we have in seismic interpretation. We want to combine information maybe from satellite images, from seismic itself, from well logs, from core measurements, from descriptive observation as outcrops, microscopic information. So hugely widely varying scales and accuracies, and somehow we have to integrate this and make sense of it and come up with a model that is consistent with all this information. So in the earth sciences, you can use machine learning for seismic phases, clustering, finding anomalies, creating seismic chimney cubes, predicting rock properties, and so on. There's a whole scala of different applications that you can think of. Let's first define what machine learning really is. Machine learning is a field of computer science that uses statistical techniques to give computer systems the ability to learn. Now, this is really the key word because it is about learning and improving the performance on a specific task just from the data without being explicitly programmed to do so. This is a subfield of artificial intelligence, which also includes genetic algorithms and fuzzy logics and other types of simulations of intelligent behavior in computers. Most people think about machine learning is neural networks. That's not true. Machine learning is just one of many different algorithms that can be used for machine learning. And it is really the key to find the best algorithm for a specific task. Now, we have in OpenDetect basically started off with neural networks like 20 years ago, and even before that, we used neural networks. And these type of neural networks are nowadays called shallow neural networks, whereas the new generation of networks are called deep networks because they have much more power, much more layers of parameters to tune, and they can handle even more complex tasks than the shallow layers that we've been using for many years now. Nevertheless, it should be realized that the type of analysis and the workflows that you're trying to do have not changed. It's exactly the same for shallow networks or deep networks. Only the algorithms have improved, and these algorithms make it possible to do new type of applications. Let's first look at what OpenDetect already has to offer. As I said, OpenDetect really started off as a seismic interpretation, seismic pattern recognition attribute analysis programming processing system. And only thereafter it evolved into a fully functional seismic interpretation system. So we have developed over the years all the tools that were needed to do machine learning. And we did this with shallow type neural networks, as they're nowadays called. Two basic types of networks are used, one for supervised work. That is, you're learning something by giving it examples. And the other by unsupervised work. That means you're giving the data and you ask the algorithm to organize, to cluster the data so that afterwards you can make sense out of it and you do your interpretation afterwards. So supervised is interpretation up front, unsupervised interpretation afterwards. And the neural networks, the multi-layer perceptrons, MLP type of neural networks we have implemented in our neural networks module, the plugin, can be used for seismic object detection, like creating seismic chimney cubes, seismic salt cubes, seismic fault cubes, seismic classification, like classifying into different seismic phases or different lithologies, but also for seismic predictions, like predicting porosities or phase shields from elastic impedance cubes. And the unsupervised networks is really for clustering data like waveform segmentation, so clustering along a seismic interpreted horizon, or in 3D attribute clustering. Now, to enable all this these type of workflows, you need a fully functional environment that allows you to create examples. We have that implemented in OpenDetect in the form of point sets, where the user can pick or choose or create locations, and at these locations, the seismic will be used and then fed into a neural network. You can also have workflows where you have wells and seismic, and then you can work with real seismic, or you can work with simulated data. And then you need tools to analyze the data, like cross-plotting, interactive testing on target sets. And because some of these workflows are really CPU intensive, you may want to do this on a single machine, but also have the option to do it over as many machines that you have access in, or run it on a cluster. And all of this is available in the OpenDetect environment. Now, many machine learning techniques and neural networks, they benefit if you do a little bit of pre-processing on the data. Instead of feeding the original seismic, you could feed it with attributes. And that's also why we actually developed the whole attribute engine in OpenDetect. As I said, it was starting off life as a pattern recognition attribute processing system. So we have the ability in OpenDetect to create 2D seismic attributes, 3D seismic attributes, pre-stack attributes. You can calculate any attribute displayed on whatever seismic section that you're interested in. You can do movie-style parameter testing. You can calculate attributes from attributes, create new attributes using Marvin logic, color blend these attributes, spectral decomposition, and so on. And obviously, you can run it in on any machine, number of machines to speed up your processing time. This is a unique capability in our machine learning portfolio, and that is the ability to simulate pseudo wells. In any well to seismic type of study, if you want to use these machine learning type of algorithms, you will hardly ever find a data set that has sufficient wells to do machine learning. Even if you have hundreds of wells, most of these wells will always inevitably be drilled on top of the structure or on anomalies seen in the seismic. So it's very rare that these wells are truly representative of all the variations that you can expect to find in your target reservoir interval. And that's where SyntRock comes in, because in SyntRock we can simulate tens of thousands of pseudo wells, combinations of different lithological layers with all the rock properties attached, and from there all the synthetic responses. And we can synthesize seismic post-stack, but also pre-stack, optionally with mode conversions and with multiples. And that information can then be used, this new database of all this data can then be used for machine learning applications to see if you can find back relationships from the seismic to the underlying rock properties. And if you can find such a relationship with a deep learning algorithm, then you can also apply it to the measured seismic response and get your predictions. Now, what is going on in the research world? Most of this research nowadays is done in Python with free libraries that have been built by companies like Google. They released their TensorFlow library, and with TensorFlow, Keras, scikit-learn, bokeh plotting, these libraries, you have a fantastic environment to do research and development. And that has also accelerated research tremendously in the last few years, because these algorithms, these libraries were freely available. People picked them up and made their own twist and continued from where others have left off. So it's a fantastic environment to research and development. What is lacking, of course, for researchers is that they have to get the data in and out of the system and all the QC and everything that needs to be done around this research. That is more difficult. And that is, of course, what we already have in OpenDetect. So what have we been doing in the last 1.5, 2 years is we have combined the OpenDetect environment with the environment of Python, TensorFlow, Keras, and scikit-learn. And that combination will be released as a new plugin to OpenDetect. And we think that will speed up machine learning R&D, but it also will bring all these latest algorithms, these new tools, available to operational geophysicists, geoscientists who can apply these new workflows, these new algorithms on their real data for real life results. So where are we, or what can you do with the machine learning plugin when we release it and when it's finished? Basically, you can do clustering, classification, and regression of data sets with only seismic, typically used for clustering 3D seismic, finding faults or imaging of faults, seismic chimneys, salt bodies, prediction of missing traces, picking velocities, mutes, increasing spatial and temporal sampling rates, transforming seismic data to, say, broadband or something else. If you want to work only with wells, then you can use these techniques for predicting missing logs, for predicting markers, for predicting stratigraphic traps, for the seismic lithophages classification, clustering of logs. And if you want to combine seismic and wells, then you can think of applications in the realm of predicting reservoir properties, explaining patterns in the data, tying wells, and so on. Now, the user interface that we have built is really thinking from the geoscientist's perspective and not from the data modeler perspective. So we think, what would you like to do? Well, you make a decision. I have only wells, I have only seismic, or I have seismic and wells. If I have only wells, then what kind of workflow would you like to do? What is the actual objective? What you want to do, log-log prediction, or maybe do a lithology classification. So it's logical thinking for a geoscientist to pick a workflow. And once you've picked a workflow, then you're basically guided through a three-step workflow. And that is always the same for any machine learning application. You select your data, train your model, and you apply the trained model. And that's what everybody will do. And of course, you have to build in enough QCs and make sure that what you're doing makes sense and is following a rigid protocol. You're not predicting something that cannot be predicted. Now, here's an example. This is actually done with our current existing neural network module. And this is the same workflow we use for seismic chimney analysis. You can also use that for creating a fault cube, as we have done here. So basically, a seismic interpreter goes in and says, well, this is a fault and this is not a fault. And of course, we have plenty of examples. There's enormous amounts of fault planes and fault sticks have been picked in the past. And these could also be used, all of them, be used as examples for this is a fault. At these locations, we then extract a number of attributes, and we also have counterexamples. This is not a fault, and we extract the same attributes, and all these attributes at all these locations are passed through a neural network that has to learn, is this a fault or is it not a fault? Then the output is applied to the actual seismic data, and the output is basically a fault probability cube. The higher the value, the more probable it is that it belongs to the fault class. And we see some results here of this classification result. This is a fault cube. If we compare this fault cube with the thinned fault likelihood attribute, which is the state-of-the-art fault attribute that is also supported in OpenDetect in the faults and fractures plugin. Then you can make a few observations. On the left, we see the neural network fault likelihood cube. And in the middle, we see the thinned fault likelihood, which is basically just a deterministic processing attribute. And what you see, if you look at these, is that TFL comes up with many more small faults. And that is sometimes not really what you want. It's a fantastic attribute, but some people complain there are too many faults to build my model, and it's very confusing to have so many. It would be nice to have a few less, and that is exactly what the neural network fault cube is giving you. Only highlights the big ones. On the right, we see the neural network fault likelihood cube, but now it also has used the TFL as an input attribute. And again, it focuses on the right one. And some of these faults, especially here in the middle, you can see a better connection. Now, another application is seismic phases classification. This example is the first workflow that we will support in our plugin. And it is based on a convolutional neural network that was researched and developed by two people from ConocoPhillips. And they released this as open source code. We picked it up and we put this same neural network in our machine learning plugin. So the idea is that you have picked just one line and you picked a number of examples to distinguish between different seismic phases. You train the network on small cubelets that are extracted at each of these locations. And then you apply the trained network to the entire seismic volume. And out of this comes this 3D seismic phases cube. Now, especially if you do log-log predictions, you want to have a whole range of QC tools, and we will support the machine learning plugin with a number of plots that can be created on the fly using the Bokeh library in Python. And here you see some examples of the kind of plots that you can expect to find in the machine learning plugin. So where are we now? We are working towards a release at the EAGE. This will be released in progressively more workflows. So we will start off with at least the clustering tool. And then soon thereafter, we will add more workflows for log-log prediction, maybe, or any other type of interesting application that we will find. We have now reached a state that we cannot do all these things, and we are inviting companies to help us doing more of these projects, and each of these projects will then also result in a new workflow that can be added to the machine learning plugin. We've written a generic proposal for this, and anyone interested in this can get a copy of that proposal for hopefully doing some work together. The idea is that the machine learning plugin will be released at the EAGE in London in June as together with version 6.6 of OpenDetect. Some references. And now it's time for a few demos. So let me start with demoing the new machine learning plugin. So this is this clustering application I've shown you here. Somebody interpreted some different seismic responses, and then he started the machine learning plugin. And then this control center pops up, and the control center, as I said, is organized in such a way that you can have workflows for just well type of work, for seismic work only, or for seismic and well type of work. Here we are doing the seismic body prediction, so we're doing a classification based on these points. Then this window pops up, and the first thing we have to do is we have to create a training data set. Now, what is unique in this application is that you can select data over multiple seismic surveys. And that is interesting. For instance, if you do a fault cube, you could create a fault neural network over many different fault cubes, train it, and then who knows, if you have a trained model, you can apply that trained model, which will then predict faults on any seismic data set that you have never seen before. So there's two modes of operation. Either you have trained models which can be applied immediately, or you build your own model from the data. You train it on this specific case, and then you apply it to this unique case. So what am I going to do here is I'm going to load a set of point sets, and these are these point sets that you see displayed over here. Now the next is that I have to specify what am I going to do. I want to extract at each of these locations seismic cubelet from this seismic volume. And then this pops up, and here I can specify the cubelet size that will be extracted from my dip-steered median filtered seismic volume. Now, then I can output that. That will be a training set with all kind of small cubelets. And then we go into the convolutional neural network that will be trained, and eventually it will be applied to the data. And let's first look at the training. So we have the training is based on either the library of Keras and TensorFlow or on scikit-learn. Scikit-learn is a library which has many more algorithms, not just machine learning, deep learning algorithms, but all kind of other very interesting algorithms that could be used for other type of applications. For example, there are factor classifiers, there are random forest classifiers. There's a lot more than just neural networks. And Keras TensorFlow is really for the deep learning, machine learning type of stuff. So we're talking about convolutional neural networks, generative adversarial neural networks, these type of networks that you read about in the research nowadays quite a bit. Then you can set a few parameters, and if you don't have so much memory, you could decimate it and run it with different randomized algorithms, subsets of the data. Okay, now let's suppose we've done this, we've trained it, and we applied it, and then what we get eventually is looking like this. So we have trained it only on this line, and we get a 3D body where all these similar patterns are recognized in 3D space. Now that can be done, of course, on many different seismic objects. I could use the same technique for just creating or recognizing seismic salt bodies. It's basically the sky is the limit here, what you should in principle be able to do with this. Okay, that is the new machine learning algorithm plugin. Let's now look at what we already have in OpenDetect as neural networks module. So this is the existing neural networks module. And the neural networks module comes from here. You can apply it on 2D and 3D seismic. You can do it for pattern recognition and property prediction. And if you go for pattern recognition, then you can select seismic attributes or seismic volumes. And you can select your pick sets to do either a supervised run or an unsupervised run. And if you go for property prediction, then you basically link your attribute seismic to your well log properties. You select your wells, you select your targets, and you extract information along the well tracks to create your data sets. Now here we see a few results. I'll just go through some of these, what we see here. Let's switch off the random line first, and let's switch off this volume. Here we see the results of a waveform segmentation. So basically we have mapped a horizon like this, and we extracted a small portion along this horizon, a small waveform, and we gave it to a neural network, an unsupervised vector quantizer, and asked it to cluster the waveforms, to segment it, and then here we look at the resulting segmentation map. So we see patterns in the data emerging, and that should trigger us to use our geological mind to see what this actually could mean. Now that can be done along horizons. It can also be done in 3D, and then we get a volume, and here we have a volume. So here we have trained the network on a number of input attributes. And applied it to the seismic to get this 3D bodies clustering from the seismic. Now again, because this is unsupervised, it means you still have to interpret the data, and you have to make sense what this red stuff means and what the other colors actually mean in terms of geological information. Supervised is different. So here we have on this line, we have again the unsupervised clustering here in the middle. But we also see here in yellow a seismic chimney response, and that is from a seismic chimney cube, and a seismic chimney cube is a supervised approach. And the way this was created was that an interpreter went in and he picked these orange locations as examples of this is a seismic chimney. And he also picked counter examples like this is not a seismic chimney. And he did this throughout the entire 3D volume. And he picked as many examples as he could for seismic chimneys and no seismic chimneys. Then he went in and extracted a whole range of attributes from the seismic. And these attributes are actually coming as default attributes with the system. And these attributes, they are then fed into a neural network that has to classify the data in two classes. Does this belong to the seismic chimney class, or is it the no seismic chimney class? And when you apply the trained neural network, you output only the yes, this is the seismic chimney class. The value should be somewhere between 0 and 1. 1 being it's very probable that it is a seismic chimney, and 0 means it is not very likely that it is a chimney. And this output is shown here in yellow, and that is the seismic chimney cube, the chimney probability. And that kind of cube can be used for fluid migration path interpretation. So supervised approach, and the last thing I'd like to show is on this random line. Here we see an acoustic impedance volume, and we have displayed here porosity logs. And we trained then a network extracted along the seismic traces that this acoustic impedance belongs to this porosity, and this acoustic impedance belongs to another porosity. And then we applied the trained neural network, and the outcome is this. Now we have a porosity cube. Okay, that is existing technology in the neural networks module, and what I showed before was the upcoming new technology in the machine learning plugin. So same workflows, but new algorithms giving up possibilities to do things better and to do new things that were not possible before.